Now to Sacramento's downtown arena plans and some tough talk today from Mayor Kevin Johnson.
Just days after the Kings owners made it clear they're not going to be paying for pre-development costs, Mayor Johnson expressed strong disappointment.
We all expected that we had an agreement. We thought we'd all be pushing in the same direction. And there's been countless tactics and antics that are just not becoming a true partnership, in my opinion.
The latest developments mean that Sacramento's downtown arena deal is starting to unravel.
And this is the city council faces another important arena vote tonight. Tom Duhane joins us from the council chamber. So, Tom, are people expecting now that this dust up is going to impact tonight's vote?
Well, according to the mayor, he doesn't think it will, although he certainly refers to it as a serious development. He thinks the council tonight will go ahead and approve the administrative steps to transfer money within the city, setting up the monies to pay for pre-development. And they'll be continuing without the Maloofs' full cooperation. You recall that the NBA had to step in and pay their first installment of $200,000. What the council's reaction tonight to what the Maloofs have been saying, we'll have to wait and hear, but we heard from the mayor today.
After a news event about cities saving energy, the mayor's comments about the Maloofs became high voltage.
I haven't, you know, publicly spoke because I've been dumbfounded for 3 or 4 days. We as a city can't be jerked around. We can't be having these ebbs and flows. You can't keep moving the finish line. And there's been countless tactics and antics that are just not becoming a true partnership, in my opinion.
The mayor says all parties understood and agreed to the funding plan for the new arena, a plan affirmed in the term sheet approved by the city council. The Maloofs would contribute $3.2 million for pre-development work.
So I find it a little bit odd that folks are saying there was an agreement all along. That's just disingenuous.
The Maloofs responded today in a statement saying, in part, pre-development costs are not the responsibility of the tenant. Moreover, the city had asked the Kings to reimburse AEG for their contribution, and we find that extremely unfair.
You can't make public statements that say one thing and then privately be doing another. I don't think that's in the spirit of what we all thought and where we thought we'd be at this point.
And the pre-development work actually starts tomorrow with engineers and architects, we're told, doing a site survey, starting to plan, but they're doing all of that on the NBA's dime, the $200,000 that the NBA has put forward. The mayor says no city money will be used until this thing is straightened out. He hopes at a mid-April meeting of the NBA. In the meantime, the mayor very significantly today saying that this situation is so serious, the arena deal may need a backup plan. Coming up at 6, you're going to hear what he said about that today. Reporting live, Tom Duhane, KCRA3 reports.
Tom, in fairness, we tried to talk to one of the Maloofs yesterday. Gavin Maloof was at the Kings game against Minnesota last night. We were firing questions at him, but obviously he did not want to answer any questions from the media on the arena plan, and they released a statement today. So my question for you tonight, Tom, is do we know if any of the Maloofs will be at tonight's city council meeting?
Well, I'm told by the Kings that the Maloofs do not plan to be attending tonight. And I don't think that's an unusual situation. When there's high criticism or high drama, they tend to stay removed from the scene and come back in when things are resolved.
A few more answers are needed before this issue is going to be resolved. Tom Duhane live tonight at City Council Chambers. We appreciate it. Thank you.